to rise. In spite of what I see, Lord, I believe. But help my unbelief, I choose to trust you. No matter what I feel, let faith arise. Let faith arise. For my champion's not dead, he is alive. Oh, and he already knows my every need. Surely he will come and rescue me.
Church, thank you so much for joining our 21-day fast of prayer. Come on, I want to invite you to worship wherever you're at right now and sing this out. This is how I find my battles. 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 It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. This is how I find my battles. 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 It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Come on and sing. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. 'Cause this is how I find my battles. 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 It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Thank you, Lord, for this day and for this special time of worship. It is always so good to be in God's presence, and we are so privileged to be able to worship Him through songs. So thank you so much, worship team. Welcome to day 18 of our 21 days of prayer and fasting. Oh, I can't believe time has flown by. My name is Claudia, and I serve here on the pastoral team at Vertical Church. Can you believe we are 3 days away from finishing our 21 days? Well, this week we are praying for our nation. And today's prayer focus is for our students, for our teachers, and all education administrators. Now, most of our students are going back to school today. And let me tell you, it's a challenging new school year for everybody, especially for kids, for teachers, and yes, even parents. So we need to really lift them up in prayer. And that's why this is such an important day of prayer. During our time together, these are the things that you can expect. We're gonna have a short devotional, then we're gonna have a personal time of prayer where you can truly go before the Lord and have some alone time with Him, speak to Him, and also listen to what He has to say to you. Then at the end, we're gonna gather to pray together, and I will bring very specific prayer points before the Lord, and all of you can join me in support. In prayer with me. So that would be wonderful. So here we go. You guys ready? Today we are talking about students, teachers, and all education administrators. And you know what? This makes me realize what an important group of people we're praying for today. When I think of this group of people, I think of the word influence. influence. Influence is the capacity or the power to produce effects on the actions, on the behaviors, and the opinions of others. In other words, what you say and what you do matter. They really, truly matter. And they can impact others in such a positive or in a negative way. So the verse that we have for today is found in Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, and it reads, "In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." In other words, everything we do should be glorifying our Father in heaven. And I love this verse because it really encourages us to shine our light. That is the light of Jesus, so others may see that. That is true influence. So I want to share with you several ways that you and I can be the light of Jesus in this sometimes, you know, very dark world. And this applies to all ages, whether you are a child in school or whether you're a person that's already retired. So here we go. Number one, you can be the light of Jesus by being thankful. Being thankful. Be openly grateful to God. Expressing your gratitude can mean either expressing your gratitude to God for His blessings, or it could be even expressing your gratitude to others for their kindness. I want you to listen to what Psalm 105, 1-2 says. It says, "Give praise to the Lord, proclaim His name, make known among the nations what He has done. Sing to Him, sing praise to Him, and tell of His wonderful acts." We can set such a good example even by the simple act of saying thanks before meals in the presence of others. This can make such a great impact. You would be surprised how much you can impact a person by just praying before a meal. It's being the light of Jesus by being thankful. Number two, by sharing and caring. We can't be like Jesus without sharing and caring. We are surrounded by hurting and desperate people, and they don't even know that anyone cares. You can be the hands and feet of Jesus to them. And I understand that we want people to know God and find His salvation, but often, you know, we have to earn that right to be heard by caring for them first. People really don't care how much we know until they know how much we care. So share the good news of God's word and care for their needs as well, whether they are material needs, emotional needs, or spiritual needs. Remember, it's really hard to listen to somebody if your last meal was 2 days ago. So you can be the light of Jesus by being thankful and by sharing and caring. Number three, by being honest. Wow, nowhere do we have a greater opportunity to shine as lights, the light of Jesus in this world, than in practicing honesty. Psalm 34:13 says, "Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking lies." Our minds and consequently our characters are to be filled with what is true. And I'm going to share with you one of my favorite verses. It's Philippians 4:8. It says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things." And that's what God calls us to do. So honesty is a strong force for good, even when nobody is looking. We need to be men, women, young people, and kids of truth. People of unquestionable integrity, honor, and sincerity. Look at what 1 Peter 2:12 says. It says, "Live such good lives among the pagans that though they may accuse you of doing wrong, they may see your good deeds and glorify God in the day that He visits us." You can be the light of Jesus by being thankful, by sharing and caring, and by being honest. Number four, by being a peacemaker. Jesus is the Prince of Peace, according to Isaiah 9:6. So as His followers, we are to be peacemakers. We need to be at peace with God, with ourselves, and with others. We are commanded to pursue peace. Hebrews 12:14 says, "Make every effort to live in peace with everyone and to be holy. Without holiness, no one will see the Lord." So remember, when it comes to conflict among other individuals with whom we have some kind of influence, we are either going to be peacemakers or troublemakers. We're either going to be bridge builders or bridge destroyers. so you can be the light of Jesus by being thankful, by sharing and caring, by being honest, and by being a peacemaker. Number five, by overcoming temptation. Listen, temptation is a daily experience, and none of us is exempt from temptation or even immune to its power. But we can resist temptation and overcome it. Another one of my favorite verses, James 4:7, it says, submit yourselves to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. So in helping us with temptation, as with all else, God is a faithful God. In 1 Corinthians 10:13, it reads, no temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it. God is so good. He always provides a way out. So we owe it to those around us to demonstrate that it is possible to overcome temptation with God's help. Now, let's review. We can be the light of Jesus in all areas of our lives by being thankful, by sharing and caring, by being honest, by being a peacemaker, and by overcoming temptation. Our influence for good can be greater than we think. Listen, don't be ashamed or afraid to let others see the light of Jesus. Let's help and encourage each other to be bold in our faith. Remember that God is looking for people that are brave and courageous. Also remember that you don't have to rely on your own strength. The Lord is always with us. He is with you every step of the way. So now as we get ready to have our personal time of prayer, I want you to meditate on these verses that I shared with you and ask the Lord, truly ask the Lord to help you be bold in your faith and to let the light of Jesus shine through you. And as you pray, we recommend that you pray with the Word of God. So read it as you pray. Also have a prayer journal so that you can write down what God speaks to you and also write any prayer petitions or prayer requests that you may have. Pray out loud so that it would help you stay focused and not distracted from anything else. And remember that after 20 minutes, we will conclude by praying together. So truly now enjoy your time of personal prayer.
Your name, Jesus, you. Serve.
Wow, what a beautiful time of personal prayer. I think it's always so important for us to have that time to connect to God and to really just express our feelings towards Him and listen to Him. Just take that time out of our daily grind, our daily busyness, and listen to God. So let's start our prayer time together. So I want you guys to go ahead and join me in prayer, support me in prayer, and just lift up your voice if you can out loud, pray and support me in prayer. So we're going to just start off with being thankful and with gratitude. So right now, Lord, we are just grateful to be in your presence. We are so thankful to you, Lord. You are King of Kings, our Lord of Lords. Father, you are our Prince of Peace. You are our provider. You are powerful and mighty. And Lord, we just worship your name. We lift your name on high. We are thankful to you, Lord, that we are breathing today, that we have life in us, Lord, that we can come to you and you listen to us, Lord. So we are just grateful to be in your presence, to be in your presence with my brothers and sisters, to just be able to be in accord as we pray together. We are so grateful for that, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And now let's just join together. Let's pray for our students that are going back into school today, going back to class today, and for our university students, for adults that are studying. Let's pray for guidance and protection. So Lord, right now we just pray for your guidance and your protection, for knowledge and wisdom to be able to study online, for our boys and girls, for our young people, all those that are studying, those students to be bold in their faith. Lord, to be light in their classrooms, even if they're virtual classrooms. Lord, Lord, for every student from kindergarten to college, we just pray that you be with them, Lord. We know that it is not going to be easy perhaps in these times, but we just pray that you give them wisdom, that you give them focus, that they may stay focused, Lord, in their task at hand, that they may be able to learn, Father, that this new way of learning do not hinder our students from growing in their education, Lord. Lord, we just lift them up in prayer, Father. We also lift up our teachers, Lord. Help them to be able to teach in a virtual setting. Lord, to be loving and kind with the kids. Help them with their technology to be able to do their job with confidence, Father. We pray for the professors in college and universities to be a good influence over their students, Father. We just pray that you be with them. Give them wisdom, Lord. Give them creativity to be able to reach their students, even from a virtual platform, Lord. So thank you, Father. Thank you for them, Lord. Guard their hearts. Guard their minds. We also pray that our kids may be surrounded by teachers and professors that honor you, Lord, that just love you, Lord, and that are not ashamed of who they are in Christ, Father. We love you. We love you, Lord, for that. Also, Lord, let's pray. Let's right now lift up our education administrators. So right now we lift up our principals, our guidance counselors, all the people that work in all areas of the school system who serve our students, for those that work in the offices, in the schools, in the universities, in our county, and in our state, serving our kids. Father, we lift up all those people that have that work in all those offices. Father, maybe they don't even work directly with the kids, but they have influence over the way they spend the money for education and over which curriculums to use during these times, Lord. So we just pray for wisdom for all those people people that work even in accounting, Father, and all the offices that have to do administrative work, that have to do with the school system, with the teaching system, Lord. We also pray for all those people that have lost their jobs, Father, all those people that have lost their jobs that have to do with the education system, Father, because we're not having classes in person anymore, Lord. We pray for provision for them. Lord, we pray that you just provide every need that they may have, open doors and possibilities for them, Lord, for all those people that have lost their jobs, specifically in the school or education system, Lord. We just lift them up, Father, in these difficult times. And Lord, we also just lift up our personal prayers. Right now, if you have any specific personal prayer petition, your personal situation, whether it be your health or something that you're going through emotional or you know, something physical or your spiritual walk. Right now, Lord, we lift up in prayers all those people that are around us and even ourselves, Father, for salvation, reconciliation with you, Father, that our kids, that our students may get closer to you, Lord. We just pray for salvation for their lives. We lift up our prayer petitions, Lord. We lift up our prayer requests right now, our personal prayer requests, Lord, that you may hear us and that you may listen to our hearts. And we thank you, Lord, because you do hear us, Lord. Lord, help me be a light. I want you to say this with me. Lord, help me be your light in this world. And Lord, help me be a light by being thankful. Say it with me. By sharing and caring. By being honest. By being a peacemaker. And by overcoming temptation. Lord, we place this day in your hands and we are confident and reassured that we are okay, that we are good because you are with us, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you guide us through our day and we place it in your hands. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today during this amazing day. Continue praying for our students, our professors, you know, our teachers, and our administrators in the education system. And remember, just join us tomorrow. We will be here again at the same time and enjoy these next 3 days that we have left. Also remember, fasting and praying doesn't have to stop just because the 21 days are over. We can continue in the same road. We hope that it becomes a habit for you, and we hope that you stay connected with us here at Vertical Church. We love you, family. Have a blessed day.